Babylon the Great, mother of harlots and abominations.
What?
They painted the walls to look like Babylon.
Yeah. Wasted time and money. It's a tire factory, right?
Well, it's L.A. Who wants reality?
Hey, it's four. Looks like a bum tip.
Patience, Phil. Patience. Pass me the whiskey.
Chinese Daiichi brand. Morning sun. It's orange, like a chicken. It's blue. And some fun.
There's a rose. How sweet. And when I need more?
Not a problem.
Must have tossed it. I'm shot, Phil.
Arnold Thorvald. Oh, no.
What?
He worked right here at the tire factory. He's working a night shift, probably.
No. That's the guy that was shooting at me. He's got to be one of them.
He's a civilian. Look, they smell the booze. It ain't gonna work, Jack.
What are you saying?
I got a drop gun and weed in the car. They get one whiff of us and we're in denim.
No.
Jack, listen to me. I'm the one that's got 5 months till a pension, huh?
Get it.
Less than 6 months ago, Arnold Thorvald, trusted employee, loving husband and father, was gunned down, then framed as a weed dealer by drunken, amphetamized cops. I love it.
The higher-ups smelled stink and let it fly. Vincennes was bumped from narc to vice. Rules retired.
I don't care about rule, but this man, Detective Jack Vincennes.
Shootings made him a nutball. Now he's working overtime, moonlighting, borrowing, anything, so he can secretly give money to Thorvald's widow and kid. All the hardship he's brought down on the poor guy's family, the is eating him up inside.
Yes. Of course. He wants, he needs redemption. Get me more.
Sid, your magazine goes after stars, politicians, celebrities. This guy's just a cop.
Everyone deserves fame. Editor's column, 9-point, Century Bold type, subhead, buffing the badge. It's press day at the Wilshire Division, Los Angeles Police. I was excluded. Hush Hush is called a tabloid, not considered legitimate press. So I'll give you the real story. It starts at morning muster with Chief Parker's latest puff piece, a film entitled Crime Crusaders, captivating a captive audience of the Chief's Blue Knights.
And jump and look sharp. New Chief William H. Parker demands military snap from his men. His goal, the most advanced law enforcement agency in the world. And no corruption allowed. Chief Parker's special creation, IAD, the Internal Affairs Division. Police policing police. Backgrounds of every man on the force are examined for past or present acts of wrongdoing. The Chief's goal, a force that's clean as a whistle. To those decent folks coming to L.A. with dreams of a proud future, the Blue Knights of the LAPD say, bienvenido, welcome. But to those intent on crime or civil strife, they say, beware. Los Angeles is no place for you.
This will be shown in schools, churches, chambers of commerce all over the country. And we don't want our message conflicting with headlines about rising crime among our Negroes or our Mexicans. So, let's demonstrate that we can keep our antisocial elements contained. Let's get out there and be tough, but courteous. Be brave, but be careful.
Captain, can I trouble you for a second, please?
Two memos a week, Jack. You're very persistent. At least you got away with words.
Thank you, sir. I need to get back in the narcotics division, sir.
Chasing that big case in the sky, lad. Still smelling the rose, are you?
No offense, sir. But you've got brand name heroin coming into this city from mainland China, and I was that close.
Have you seen it? You won't say, which means you have, but you can't tell me. Jack, for your own sake, it's best we let sleeping dogs lie.
Yes, sir.
I'll be right back. You stay right here, okay? Jack!
Yeah.
We picked up this kid begging for food on Pico. His mother, Colette McGuire, she hasn't been home for 3 days. Says she's a waitress on the corner of 6th and Sears.
Poor kid. Folks on that corner cater to a different appetite. Look, I'll work the snitches in the area, see what we dig up. Hey, kid. You hungry? Okay. Let's get you something to eat, and then we'll go find your mother.
Police, policing, police. You don't mind being hated?
Hated? I think the rank and file want a clean department. The officers we want us.
Mind something a little personal?
Try me.
IAD is a plum assignment, but then your father was a legendary cop who's now a city contractor.
So did he get me the job? Ask him. And then duck the punch. Self-made is a family tradition.
Good answer. If I don't get a little rough, I'm not doing my job. All right, let's get a shot of Sergeant Exley, front of this. When I was on Guadalcanal, I heard about you single-handedly taking that hill.
Can you get my DSC in the shot? Oh, excuse me.
Background profiles with hush-hush story potential. Now, let's see.
What actually makes a good cop? An abusive father, a broken home, a stint in the Marines?
Sure.
That's what made Patrolman Bud White.
Look at him. Baby. Studio residence, Fred. Two floors of raging beauties. Forget about a stance. No men beyond the lounge.
Yes, and the babe that's gonna put some real twist on Bud's future has just hit town.
Clenched teeth. You look very Barbara Stanwyck. I like it.
There's something you'll like. Little Dorothy's left Kansas.
Amazing how they turn them out faster than I can turn them over.
There are strict rules on male visitors. No one is allowed, even in the lounge, after midnight.
That's why I wanted to stay here.
You'll room with a nice young lady named Pat Levine. She's been here almost a year.
Oh, good. She can show me the ropes.
My name is Catherine. I'm the residence director. If you have any questions, that's why I'm here.
Thank you, Catherine. I already feel at home.
You're very welcome.
So, Kathy, what have we here? A Miss Lynn Bracken. How about these credits? Runner-up Miss Arizona.
Sixth and Cirrus Street. Tawdry bars, rooms that rent by the hour. It's the corner where a little boy's mother catered to a different appetite. A trail of snitches leads Jack to a shabby room. But it's too late. Lucian's mom stepped on a rainbow and went home to Jesus.
Well, Mommy, at least you died happy.
That's right, Jack. The mother and that little boy she left behind are both victims of the Rose.
See, Chang, no permits.
City permit, very hard to get. You take time. Take this time. Take scar. Take time.
Number 18, that one.
Hey, that's private property.
Wrong, patrolman. Blocker's a police department property. And as such, no place for extorted goods. 34.
Just a jerk.
The record will show that scarves and ties extorted from Chinatown merchants were found in the lockers of officers Smitty and Thorpe.
Relax, Sergeant. Chinese don't pull permits.
Right.
They give gifts. It's an LA tradition.
Well, hey, Exley. Search it, huh? Stensland, 39.
Come on.
Don't do that.
Well, this is a suspension, Stensland.
Give me that.
Give me
keep away from Exley. Keep away from Exley.
Hey, Exley. You want some hot goods? There you go. Hot off my crotch.
Good check, Jack.
Let's all come clean,
there you
huh?
Go. There you go.
Yeah.
Chief Parker's pet. His father paid dearly to keep it out of the press, but I paid more. On the QT and very hush-hush.
another thing? My mother said a waiter at the LA Country Club smirked at her. I mean, that's the kind of people who read that disgusting magazine.
Who cares?
I do. I take your side whenever people ask me why you even joined the police. And I know it's just a part of a bigger plan, but it's humiliating. You know, your father says it's important that you turn this thing around.
You talk to my father?
Edmund, we're going to be a family.
I do not want you talking to him about me.
Okay. Okay, I'm sorry.
How sorry?
Edmund. No, not now. Edmund, my parents
are in Newport until noon.
What about your job?
I'm taking what is known as personal time.
It's just so wrong, Edmund.
It feels awfully right, doesn't it?
This house was for sale.
Yeah. Just got the listing. They're asking $4,000 for it, but they're six payments behind.
Six payments?
Nearly $200. If the bank takes it, they get nothing, so they're motivated.
Well, it sure is a fine house.
I'll tell you what, I'll give you my card. You can call me directly.
Hey, Book.
Big Jack the V. Got something down on the Angel?
No, I'm not betting. I want you to take a look at something.
What?
The weight, it's gold.
This is for the 50 over?
No, look, something's come up. I need more. 200.
I can't help you, pal.
The review board was against me. IAD needs teeth, or it's going to look like a sham to keep civilians off the chief's back.
One good prosecution will give it validation, don't you think?
But something big, not just patrolmen taking scarves and ties.
There's a rumor. This has to be a very private discussion, Edmund.
You've known me since I was a boy.
Your father left the badge for the private sector. I feared we might have to borrow it. But glad that doesn't happen.
Yes, he likes having friends on the force.
Something big's coming your way. It's a case involving a famous personage. I am given to understand that you'll work it alone.
And I won't share the credit.
I thought you'd like that.
Robbed unemployment office, killed a guard, suspects on holding hostages.
Here's how luck is made for a cop.
And today's hand is dealt for Bud White.
Kill the guard. We chased him. I got old people in there.
You give me an unmarked car, clear out of here! Now!
Talk to him, Stens. I'm going in.
Okay, we hear ya. I'll radio for a car. Don't shoot anyone. Nobody gets hurt.
Hello in there. I'm Captain Smith. I'm in charge.
Just hold it there, Fuzz.
Calm yourself, son. I've got the authority to get you what you need.
Now one more step and you're a dead man.
I'm here to get you out of this. Bear with me, son.
I'm getting tired of waiting in here.
White's under the house.
Anything I can get you, talk to me. Let me know what's on your mind. Your car's on its way, son. Bear with me. Hey. Nobody's gonna get hurt.
Clear out of here, all of you! I'm sending out another body!
Stay calm, son.
Give me that car! Clear out!
I want you to do me a favor, first of all. Send the old dogs out as a gesture of goodwill. How about that?
Inside. He's dead.
Good job, lad. Good job. So you were a Marine. My brother was killed at Guadalcanal.
A lot of good guys got it there, sir. I'm sorry.
Your parents alive?
No, sir. They died when I was just a kid.
I see you take a pretty tough position with wife beaters, lad. Came within a hair's breadth of assault charges yourself. Lucky thing the man in question survived, don't you think?
Yes, sir. I just don't think a man should ever hit a woman, sir.
I need strong-minded men who get a job done, officer. If there's guilt but no evidence, evidence will be found. If physical punishment will prompt a confession, then we'll get our confession. And if a man has killed and he's running, he'll be shot down. You're one of the men I'm looking for?
What are you saying, Captain? I don't have a problem.
I didn't think so. You'll be part of a special surveillance team. In your downtime, you'll assist at homicide.
Yes, sir. I will not disappoint you, sir.
When I call for you, you drop what you're doing and you come running. Do you understand?
Whatever you need, I'll do it. Sir, I'll be there.
But I don't know enough about you. Just when I think you might, you try a different line.
Look, I can help you unwind. It's 25 and it is pure oil.
I'm looking for weight, darling. I'll set someone aside for you if you help me cop what I need. Ah, you're listening. Good. When I first hit town, I lucked into something special. Color of the Roses, you seen it? It's amazing.
Roses, huh? No, I never seen anything like that.
Nice to meet you, Renata.
I told you, I don't know anything about that.
That's what she said. Your eyes said something different. LAPD. Possession with intent to sell.
I did a porn job once, okay? Some photos for a slam book. They paid me with the rose.
Who?
Creeps. Man, I don't know.
That won't do, Renata.
Hey, you know what? There was this one guy there, and he was picking up real young tricks for a party or something.
Whose party?
I don't know. It was a lie. I mean, a girl said they were going to Pierce Patchett's house. You know, that real rich guy. You know him, right?
No. But I will. Knock yourself out.
Come on to my house, in my house, I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house, in my house, I'm gonna give you
candy. Hi, Pat. Hi. Darlene said you're going to Pierce Patch's luau.
Right, honey, along with all Hollywood.
They sent me an invitation, too, but I can't seem to find it.
You didn't happen to see it?
No. But don't worry. They'll have your name at the door.
You think so?
With your looks, you're in.
So what brings Chief Parker's Crown Princeling to Bel Air?
He's IAD. It must have something to do with the cop.
We follow a sex goddess to the home of a fix-it man for sex-exploited stars. Now, why does Barney Cattleman, Columbia Law School, class of 42, need Edmund Exley?
Edmund Exley, this is Marilyn Monroe.
Miss Monroe.
No, please, just Marilyn.
Good.
I'm not privy to the words, but it might concern a mysterious event. 3 months ago, at Miss Monroe's sweet little home in Santa Monica, our heroine sat alone. A man appears at her door. Our cameras caught only his back, but Marilyn gave him entry. He set up a movie projector. But what did he show her?
It's not me.
We seized this in a porno raid. It's evidence. It's got to be shown in court.
You can't let that happen. Burn it. Destroy it. I'll pay you. Just tell me what you want.
Okay, sweetheart.
Did he show you a badge? Any kind of ID?
A police badge. That's why I let him in. Please, can you help me?
Yes. Please, don't worry. I'll take care of it.
Nice kid. You know, She had to do some things to survive.
Well, you're not saying that she,
Who knows?
Thank you, Mr. Cattleman.
Sure. Hmm. Look at him. Sid Hudgens. Scum. He's got the scent. If he ever finds that film, she's finished.
Big Jack.
Just so you don't go around saying I never did you a favor.
What's the call, Fook?
Well, you're tapped. You owe me. I'm gonna do you a favor. Starlet situation, Jack. Chick from the studio residence is turning tricks out of a Hollywood court. Same time every night. You need 200 bucks, don't you? You work her, you work the John. It's good.
You're just giving me this.
Like a bigger fish to fry. You pay back the 50 you owe me, plus another 50 and we're square, okay?
You're all heart. All heart. Victor 20. I'd like a DMV check on a California license plate, 3 George 2972.
Stand by. Did you miss me? Are you ready for me? Oh, yeah. Do you like these?
Yeah.
Heel. Come on. There you go. See how they stand straight up? Hmm? You know why? Because you are such a bitch and lover. Drive me nuts. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. There's my guy.
Don't mind me.
Yeah, and who the hell are you? A private dick? Did the wifey send you?
No, sweetheart. I'm the real deal. LAPD Vice.
Oh, my God.
You, Scram. Let's see what we got here.
You know, we're not even breaking the law. I'm not some call girl. He's not even paying me.
Patricia, got yourself a SAG card. Studio residence card, overdrawn checking account. You know, with the prostitution bust right now, Patricia, you can kiss your promising little career goodbye.
So? Why don't you cut me a little slack? Believe me, I can really make it worth your while. Hmm?
Sit down on the bed. Now.
Sure.
You got yourself an invitation to Pierce Patchett's luau at the Beverly Bay Club. How'd you rate this?
I know Pierce. He's a friend. Why can't he start his car?
Don't worry about him. Pierce Patchett's luau. I'm your date.
What?
Better than going to jail, honey.
Yeah. Sure, whatever.
And you will introduce me to Pierce Patchett.
Oh, I will. Officer.
Good night. You looking for this? Whatever she was worth to you, this has got to be worth double. Let's see. An almost starlet. Yeah, a deuce will do it. What do you want me to call the missus on Larchmont and tell her you're having car trouble? $200, buddy. Cough it up. Smart thinking. Have a good night.
Where is it lovelier than Hancock Park? Old homes, old money, and the old homestead for Edmund Exley. The sweet Ileana on his arm, the perfect occasion to brag how he'll catch the blackmailer of America's sex goddess.
Edmund, why didn't you tell me? That's terrific. A case like that could really help your career.
That's why I took it.
That's why you got it.
Why I got it?
Yeah.
You called a favor on Dudley Smith.
I called a favor on Chief Parker, so make sure the case sticks.
It'll stick.
Well, I just think it's great your father could help out.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Papa loves Mambo. Mambo loves Mambo.
Pierce finances movies, and I want him to see my photos. Don't screw this up for me.
I just introduced me to passion.
Hey, happy 4th of July.
Hey, happy 4th. Security job.
Yeah, $2 an hour.
Well, tonight I am the guest, but my date, excuse me.
Have fun.
And this one was for Peter Gowland.
Are you one of Randy's girls? Wait right here, okay? How'd she get in?
No idea.
Mr. Patchett, Jack Vincennes. Well, I can tell he was taken by your photos.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started him to hum. Still, it's a real good bet. The best is yet to come. Best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine?
Lynn, darling, there you are. Ranny Sansom. We met at the studio residence hall. I'm the reason you're invited.
Really? I don't remember.
Oh, we met on the fly, sweetheart. But now we'll get acquainted.
Oops, I thought it was the ladies. You got some of that for, me?
My friend's diabetic.
Yeah, right. Come on, I've skin popped a couple of times.
Yeah, sure, babe. Just lock the door.
Oh. I didn't see that.
So you're from where?
Bisbee, Arizona.
Mm-hmm.
A small town near the Mexican border. Not much of a place.
Bisbee. I love it. It sounds like buzzing bees. Bisbee.
And naturally, you want to act.
Well, that's what I'm hoping. Mm-hmm. I did some theater in Tucson, but I haven't been able to see an agent here. If you don't know people...
Well, now you do know people.
I knew you'd love her.
Mm-hmm.
What's your drink? Cheers.
She's not for you, Jack. Just took her vows in the Sisterhood of Sappho. A lesbian.
And you would be?
Sydney Hudgens, Hush Hush Magazine. Been wanting to meet you.
Me?
I've got something in our celebrity hophead file. Bobby Mitchum is once more in the vice-like grip of marijuana addiction. I bring a photographer, you make the bus. A hero.
Sorry, I avoid trash.
I'll throw it on the couch.
Isn't that your date?
This is great.
Here.
How about my new zoom lens?
These are Iba zoom lenses.
Trash. Trash. Last thing you said.
Yes, what you write.
I've simply chosen a genre of very vivid portraiture, and not without literary precedent. I doubt you've heard of Marcel Proust.
Remembrance of things past. It's about a queer.
So Jack is literate. By a queer, not about a queer.
By a queer, about a queer. I don't need you, Sid. Oh, but I think you do. You ever read Lord Jim?
Yes, by Joseph Conrad.
Lord Jim, story of a man who commits a single act of weakness, which haunts him, comes to define his life. It's always something to relate to in quality lit. Isn't there, Jack?
Call me
on that Bobby Mitchum thing. You should have a nice little drink.
No, I'm here with someone.
Come on, baby face. Just a drink.
I really can. I'm sorry.
Oh, sure you can.
Hey,
come
hey,
on.
Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, don't ever touch me, hump.
Mr. Patchett wants to see her.
Oh, she's Patchett's dog. Okay. I can respect that. Another time, huh, honey?
Is Pierce still in the den?
I don't know.
So Pierce didn't really want it?
No, but I thought that...
Well, he thought right. What a jerk.
I'm just doing a job, so...
Are you a bodyguard?
No. Nothing like that. I'm just working tonight as a bouncer, making some extra cash. I'm a cop.
A cop? Wow. So if I'm ever in trouble, I run to you.
Oh, well, I'm here if you need me. Uh-oh. Patchett's butler is watching me. I'm not supposed to be too friendly with the guests.
I see. There's gonna be fireworks. And maybe I can meet you in the terrace. We can talk some more. No one will notice us.
Sure.
Oh, Lynn Bracken.
I'm Bud White.
Nice to meet you, Bud.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Lynn.
Okay.
Excuse us. Who the hell are you? Your worst nightmare, LAPD detective. Who's been picking your party favors?
Security, where's Watson? Get me security.
No, you and I, we're gonna talk.
Get him out of here. Come on, Jack.
Jack. Patchett, one day it's just gonna be you and me.
Baby.
sexy, baby. Like at the party. Gotcha.
Please.